Hi guys, in today's video, I will show you how to create a wildcard certificate on pfSYN. So the reason why we use wildcard certificates is because we have, especially in my setup, I have a subdomain. So if you're just setting up the certificate for your domain only, it means that your subdomain not gonna work for your it's not gonna work for your subdomain. So what is wildcard? So as you seen my domain, it sys admin 102.tech. So but if I set it up for the let encrypt certificate for sysadmin 102.tech, only sysadmin 102.tech gonna have the green lock icon right there. When I try to go to a pfsyn.sysadmin.tech, it's still gonna be not secure because pfsyn is different than the domain, it's a subdomain. So that's the reason why I have to set up the wildcard so it's work with the subdomain. Same thing if I issue the certificate to pfsyn.sysadmin.tech, all the subdomain is not gonna work. For example, I have a micro tick here. And if I set up the certificate for pfsyn.sysadmin 102.tech, that only work for pfsyn.sysadmin.tech, but it will not work for microtik.sysadmin.tech. So if we set up the wildcard, it would work for any subdomain. And if you do have a subzone, you will also have to set up the certificate for a subzone, because that will not work in this scenario. So for example, it's gonna be your host name dot sub dot your domain name, that a sub zone. And for that setup, you will also have to re-a another wild certificate for each individual sub zone. And with that, let's get started. So first, we need to install the ACME package to set it up. All right, so we're gonna go to Packet Manager, and we're gonna go to Unavailable Packages, and it should be under ACME, the first one that you see. And we're gonna go ahead and install the ACME package, confirm. So the let encrypt certificate is only good for 90 days. So each every 3 months you have to renew the certificate. And ACME make it easier to renew the certificate. It automated the process. All right. So now we should have ACME installed it on our pfSYN. Yep. All right, so next step, we're gonna open up ACME. We're gonna go to services and ACME certificates. And first step, we're gonna re-a the account keys. So I'm gonna go to account keys. And I'm gonna add a new one. And for the name, I'm just gonna call it sysadmin 102.tech. Description, same thing. Wildcard. We gotta go with the reduction. So for the email address, put in whatever the email address that you want to be notified when your certificate expire. Let Encrypt gonna send you an email and say that hey, your domain certificate gonna be expired soon. You need to renew it. And after that, you're gonna create a new account key. And once you're creating the account key, you're gonna register the ACME account key. Alright, so we're gonna save it. Next step, we're gonna add the wildcard certificate. So when you go to certificates, and we're gonna add the new one, and the name, I'm gonna put it my domain name. It's gonna be sysadmin102.tech wildcard. And then you're gonna select the ACME account. If you have more than one account, then you have to select it. But if you only have one account key, then it's automatically select that one for you. And then next step, domain send list. So this is depend on what domain service that you use. The one I'm using is Cloud DNS. So this information, you can obtain it from your domain service provider. All right, so I have the authorized ID, gonna be 4578. And the domain name gonna be sysadmin102.tech. I'm gonna enable that one. And we're gonna add one more. So for the domain send list, I see a lot of users setting up as where they put the domain name with the wildcard right away. So according to the NetGate document or pfSense, you have to have the domain send list. It should contain entries for the base domain, which is my base domain is sysadmin102.txt, and it also have to have it's for the subdomain. For whatever reason, a lot of people set it up with the wildcard for the subdomain only. It should have for both your base domain and your subdomain. And the setting for both the base domain and the subdomain should be the same. All right, so this one gonna be asterisk dot sysadmin102.tech. So whatever come before, whatever host name came before sysadmin102.tech is gonna be certified by Let Encrypt also. All right, and once again, same setting, 4578. And that's it. We're gonna save it, and we're gonna go to general settings. We're gonna enable the cron entry. So what it does is it's gonna automate the process to automatically re-aid the ACME using a ACME package to renew the Let Encrypt certificate. And it also write the ACME certificate for to the configurations to a different format. All right, we're gonna save it, and we're gonna go back to certificate, and we're gonna issue and renew. All right, now that we have a certificate successfully created, and it works for both the base domain, which is sysadmin102.tech, and it also works for the any subdomain that come with the wildcard .sysadmin102.tech. All right, so in order to change the certificate for PFSync to have the let encrypt certificate, we're gonna go to system, I'm gonna go to advanced, and from advanced SSL TLS certificate, we're gonna change this to sysadmin102.tech. All right, and we're gonna save it. Should redirect us to the new URL with the new loaded certificate. All right, I'm gonna close this out and reopen it. All right, now that you see that we no longer have a not secure icon here, but instead we have the lock for it mean that it desired connection is secure and encrypted, and the certificate actually certified by a certificate authority or CA. So certificate valid, and you click on it, you're gonna say issue to sysadmin102.tech. And it issued by let encrypt, issue on today day and expire 3 months from now. And that concludes my today tutorial. In the next tutorial, I will cover how to set up the HA RASI package with the let encrypt certificate. And if you think the tutorial is helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like, and give me a thumbs up. And if you can share the video, I would really appreciate it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye bye.